Hey, this is John at Freshwater Systems. I want to talk to you today about reverse osmosis. A lot of people wonder, is reverse osmosis the way to go? But we're going to talk about a few things to consider before making your purchase. So the first question is why? Why do you feel you need to purchase an RO system? Is it because of a specific contaminant like fluoride or arsenic? Or is it more of an aesthetic issue like taste and odor things? Reverse osmosis is great at getting rid of dissolved inorganics, and arsenic and fluoride are going to be in that list. You need RO for that. But for chlorine taste and odor issues, maybe not quite as extensive as reverse osmosis. The second thing to consider is the water source. The water that treats your or comes into your house and is going to feed this reverse osmosis system. If you're on city water or municipally treated water, it's going to be relatively free of chemicals and bacteria, but it's going to have a level of inorganic dissolved solids. Your reverse osmosis system is going to do a great job at reducing those. If you're on a private well, then there's a potential for harmful pathogens and chemicals, and reverse osmosis is a great choice as part of a whole house treatment system. The third thing is water pressure. Reverse osmosis needs water pressure to function properly. Without it, it's not going to work. If your household pressure is below 40 psi, chances are good you're going to need to add pressure with the use of a booster pump. If you're on well water supply, make sure your well pressure or your tank is set high enough for the system to work. Another consideration is the level of dissolved solids in your water could affect how pressure makes reverse osmosis work. We can always talk about that at another time. The fourth thing to consider is water demand, or how much you and your family are going to use. Every person, according to nutritionists, should drink half their weight in ounces every day. So if you're 160 pounds, you should be drinking 80 ounces of water per day. And that water should be high quality, like what you're going to get from a reverse osmosis system. The other thing, are you going to hook it up to your ice machine? Do you have a through-door dispenser in your refrigerator? And quite frankly, RO water is excellent to mix for teas, juices, any beverage, and to cook with. All right, the fifth thing to consider is your budget. How much is it going to cost to purchase the system, and how much is it going to cost for installation, especially if you hire someone to do it for you? The other thing to consider in that budget is the ongoing maintenance cost. How much does it cost to replace the filters and the membrane on an annual and then biannual basis? Well, there's a couple of styles of ROs available, and this leads me into our sixth thing to consider, and that's the style of the unit. Some of these units are what we call quick change, where the filters are very easy to remove. They simply quarter turn and they come off, and you take the new filter and you turn it in and quarter turn back on. Very easy. So if you're not even mechanically minded, you could handle changing those filters out. The downside to that is, as you can imagine, these filters are a little more expensive. The other style is more of a traditional housing with filter inside that you pull the housing off and you're going to throw that cartridge away, put a new cartridge in, and replace the housing. We kind of lean towards that style because it's a little more environmentally friendly, less impact of throwing this plastic housing into the trash every time you change them out. Finally, the last thing to consider is part of the installation process. These require a dedicated faucet and a drain connection. Well, as a plumbing code, any kind of appliance that we're hooking up to the feed supply and to the drain supply needs backflow prevention. Well, we do that with reverse osmosis systems by use of an air gap faucet. This is just simply a way for the drain water to pass through the body of the faucet, so that the drain water can never come back to the RO. Well, these things need to be installed. And if you live in an apartment or you rent a house where you're not going to be able to install a faucet or do any kind of alteration of the plumbing, then this product probably won't work for you. But in closing, these things are awesome. They do a great job at getting rid of crucial contaminants as well as dissolved inorganic mineral that can be harmful. We sell a lot of them throughout the country. The Midwest, Texas, California, all benefit from better drinking water. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you got something out of it. We'll be doing more of these, so stay tuned. This is John from Freshwater Systems.